Welcome back to Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Today's episode, powered by Perfect Sports Nutrition, is all about the differences between boxing and kickboxing and why the transition is difficult. All right, in today's episode, we're going to talk about some of the differences between straight boxing and kickboxing and a lot of the troubles that happen transitioning between the two. As a kickboxer transitioning to boxing, you'll see a lot of weird technique. It might look a little off to you, and I'm gonna explain why. And kind of the same problems might happen if you're a boxer now transitioning into kickboxing, which you can see a lot in MMA now. So one of the biggest problems and why I'm doing this video, it was brought up to me during and preparing and planning for the Conor McGregor fight, right? Thinking about Conor McGregor and his training, a lot of the things you noticed is before he had that karate stance, right? Bladed, moving, bouncing, being a little bit more unorthodox with his striking. However, once he started fighting Floyd Mayweather and started focusing on his boxing, something changed and he became more susceptible to calf kicks. So this is one of the main reasons now, it's because of mixed martial arts that you're seeing straight kickboxers having trouble with boxing and boxing having straight trouble with kickboxing, right? So let's look at it and why they have difficulty. So the easiest way to look at it, I feel, is from a kickboxer trying to transition into boxing, okay? So the first thing to me, why it looks very, very awkward, okay? It's not very clean, is because of the stance length, okay? In kickboxing, when you wanna kick, a longer stance is more efficient. You get more power. If you're kicking from a short stance, right? You don't get as much power. There's not enough length, there's not enough movement of your hip, there's not enough weight transfer from the ground into the end of the kick, okay? So that's one of the issues, right? The stance. Now, when we talk about the stance, right? In kickboxing, we like to have the front foot pointing forward. Why does the front foot pointing forward? Because it's easy to check, right? If I'm bladed, more like a traditional boxing stance, right? Which is one, narrower and more sideways, it's hard for me to block, and this is why a lot of boxers in mixed martial arts get that calf taken or the low kick taken. The side, the bladed stance doesn't help for that, okay? So even one for blocking, it sucks, but now if I want to kick with my right side, to turn this foot all the way over, it's slow, it's predictable, and you're not gonna get enough power because of the power line. You have to step all the way to the outside of this line to be able to generate the power, stepping out to get more of that weight transfer. So the boxing stance doesn't let you kick, right? So as a boxer, as a kickboxer now, when I kick, this is my attacking stance. Look how long I want my stance, right? So even when we throw our hands, right, we like to have that long stance. So the problem with the long stance punching, what happens now is I can't bring my weight forward. And getting my head on top of my knee is where you generate weight, power, transfer. So look at this one too. A kickboxing style would be here, nice and long, right? I'm long so I can now boom, have the length to get a nice long kick, right? So long foot pointing forward. Now a more of a boxing one too, right? You'll see more narrow, but watch my back foot. See how I close the back foot now, right? And that one gets my head over my knee, but it brings weight transfer, right? Now I have more weight behind this hand, right? Boom. Here, now I could kick, but look when I throw my hook, I'm in a close range. Doesn't favor my kicking. So now, if I throw one, two, three like a boxer, right? Boom, boom, boom. Okay? Now, look at my position. One, I'm closer. Two, my feet pivot a lot in boxing, right? We're gonna go one with the jab, two, three, right? I'm moving a lot, right? A lot of this, a lot of shoulder movement, right? So, the long stance now, right? Doesn't bring that weight transfer. It doesn't even let me kind of move forward. So watch when a kickboxer throws his punches. You're gonna notice that long stance and less pivot on the front foot, right? So watch my front foot, kickboxing style, one, two, three. See how I barely pivoted? Even when I pivot, it's slight, right? Very little because I know I'm gonna kick after, right? So I'm not gonna be here, one, two, three. Now it's too slow, predictable, right? So kickboxing, one, two, three. Bang. So the front foot, the long stance, helps you transition between weapons, block low kicks, but it just looks technically wrong, right? Not getting this back foot up just looks funny, right? So if I'm, you can see now the differences in a boxing style with minimal pivot, right? I can kick, right? One, two, three, kick. Now when I want to get inside, so you can see the head position, right? I'm inside ripping shots because I'm in weight transfer. If I'm in a long stance here with kickboxing, I can't get that extra dig, more weight forward in that long stance. Now, the other thing you're gonna notice is, like I just mentioned, the lack of pivoting in the feet. We tend not to do it in kickboxing, right? So, one, two, three, way too much. So, one, two, three, that's the lead foot. Back foot, this is where the big difference I find. In the long stance, you get away with not having to pivot the back foot, okay? This is where, number one, where I look to see if someone's traditionally a boxer versus kickboxer. That back foot is the big giveaway, right? So a lot of kickboxers will keep the back foot this way, right? So I barely pivoted, right? It's still in almost my L, so I can really launch a kick. Where the boxer's gonna turn that back foot, which gets more hip. So biomechanically, for more power, right, I want that hip to turn over if I want more weight. Boom, right? I need that hip to turn, right? Instead of doing this, where I'm barely turning, you can see now I'm using my weight, my legs, the pivoting. Okay, so that is one of the biggest issues. Now, the other thing you're gonna notice is defense. Defense changes a lot between boxing and kickboxing, right? We talked about the lower body issues, but a lot of differences happen upstairs, which make kickboxers look a little bit more awkward, and that's kickboxers not being able to pivot and use the shoulder rotation momentum, especially with counter shots. You might see a quick little slip here and there, but traditionally you're learning to block more with a parry, with high head guard, or footwork, right? So a lot of this head movement that you see in boxing isn't there, right? We don't want to be in there dipping our head here for no reason, right? That's dangerous with kicks and knees coming. So the one thing I'd like to see a little bit more with kickboxers is using a little bit of the shorter stance to move the head. So if I want to move my feet and head, you see my feet and my shoulders all work together, right? Even if I'm here, you'll see a lot of preloading the shot. So if I'm getting hit, I'm more using a rolling of the punch style in boxing rather than my hard blocking the shell here, Dutch style hard counters, right? So understanding that, using the shoulders here, right, to help you move, right? And you always don't need this hand here because of the head movement, right? Kickboxers get blinded here. So the kickboxer doesn't have the hand lead hand positioning that a boxer would. So a lot of times the kickboxer gets destroyed straight boxing with a good jab, right? So if you're stuck with your hand here and a boxer's just keeping occupied with the space, hitting on angles, you get blinded in the high very easily. So if you're gonna transition a little bit, have a little bit more fluidity in the lead hand and moving your head a little bit. And just understand, everything works together, from moving my head, from my feet, all transfer together. You don't need that long stance that we always have in kickboxing. Now, this video I want to conclude with how it makes sense for mixed martial arts, right? So it makes sense that understanding that one, mixed martial art is the blending of the two arts. You need to have some good boxing concepts and you need good kickboxing concepts. But the idea of being able to mix and match both of them is extremely important. So what I mean by that is, when it's time to throw punches, it's okay to get into more of a traditional boxing stance. And if they're not attacking your leg, continue to do that, right? If you're not attacking my legs and my hands are winning, right, I'm gonna put myself in the position where I can hit you the hardest and potentially knock you out. right? That's obviously the name of the game. So understanding that is really important. But if you start kicking my leg, I'm bladed, I'm banging you up now, you start hitting my leg, I have to make the adjustment, right? Now I have to put my front foot a little bit more forward. So I might throw my hands more like a kickboxer to set up my kicks now, right? Less pivot, longer stance, but I just have to be aware that I can transition. Now, I created a video previously on transitioning mid-combination, right? So I can start with a hard boxing combination with good boxing footwork, right? One, two, hip turn, bang, bang, bang. Now all of a sudden, I see an exit, and all of a sudden, now I transition to a long kickboxing stance because I want to kick, right? So the difference of inside with rotation in the shoulders, in my head, pivoting in my feet, I'm boxing, right? Angled shuffles, hitting, angling, see how my feet are pivoting, blocking, but now I want to transition to kickboxing. Lengthen my stance, nice and long, boom, kick, kick, boom. So you can see the difference, long kickboxing versus inside power boxing, okay? So mix and match, inside, lengthen to kick, boom. So the true master is the one that can mix and match between both. Now, if you've come a traditional Taekwondo, karate versus boxing, it might be a little bit different. But understanding the two is very important, and I hope you learned a lot from this video. Hope you enjoyed today's episode. Make sure you support the channel sponsors, Hayabusa, Perfect Sports Nutrition, BazookaShop.com, and last but not least, BazookaTraining.com. For $9.99 a month, you can get full training episodes taught by me. We've got home workouts, bag workouts, tutorials, sparring drills, 4 videos a week for only $9.99 a month, and they supplement this. This is just the appetizer, the main meals at BazookaTraining.com. We'll see you next time here at Bazooka Kickboxing and MMA. Boom.